Hello students, today we are going to see a connection between VP.NET application and SQL Server 2008. So let's get started. I'm going to create a new project in VP.NET, that is Visual Studio 2008. Let's give a name SQL connection demo. Here, while connecting to the database, you make sure you have installed SQL Server on your system, that SQL Server 2005 or SQL Server 2008, whichever it may be. I have SQL Server 2008 R2, Service Pack R2. You may have SQL Server 2008, SQL Server 2005, whatever it may be. Just follow these steps to connect your VP.NET applications with your SQL database. Just right click on your project, add new item. This will take time. Click on service-based database. You will get a database 1.mdf file. In case of Access database, you will get .mdb. In case of SQL, you get mdf file. I am giving name college .mdf. It's a default extension for service-based database. Okay, so here college.mdf database file has been created. And from here you can see a connection string has been created that you may require while doing your coding. So it is better to copy this and click on next. Okay. And click on finish. So this college.mdf is an empty database that we have to add some tables into it. So here in Server Explorer window, I am going to add some tables. Right click, add new table. So here I want teacher table in college database. So teacher ID, which I required as numeric, it may not contain null value. Teacher name, tname. I want this as varchar 50, teacher subject, t subject. This is also varchar 50. So this is table design. I want to switch. I will give this name first, teacher name. Okay, here you can see table teacher has been created in the database college.mdf. And if you want to add some values into the database, into the table, sorry, so go to teacher, show table data, right clicking. By right clicking on the table, I want to insert record number 1, teacher number Neha Biradar, subject C programming. We have done with our database and a teacher table inside the database. You can create more than one tables by right clicking on this same table listing in single database. So now it's time to connect our college.mdf database with our VP.NET application. Just I wanted to take a data grid view from the toolbox. Just click on data grid view and drop on the form. You can make database connectivity from here also, or I'm going to show you how to connect your database to the VP.NET application with the help of coding. That it is much better than this wizard. So we'll see here is no method is listed, that I have to add some methods into the XSD file here that I have created. Just drag that table and release here. After this, you may show some data sets and a teacher table. That's it. On the form load, you can see this code after creation of XSD file. I just want to check where this connects with the database or not. Execute it using F5, and here you can see our data grid view 1 has the data which we have entered into the table teacher. But if I want to connect this form without wizard, that means I want to connect this form with coding. So in that case, I don't need these data sets and data adapters and all. I just want to write some code. So go to the form load event and delete all the code that has been created automatically after making connection by the wizard. So for database connection, we require a connection object as new SQL client dot SQL connection. If you want to import that class, you can system.data.sqlclient. So here, if I want a command object as new, there is no need to mention SQL client.sql command. You can directly put it as SQL command object. I want data adapter as new SQL data adapter and a data set to manipulate the data grid view. DS as new data set. I have done with creation of these four objects. Remember, you don't require any extra objects. If you handle these four objects perfectly, there is no need to create more than one connection, more than one command, and more than one data adapter and data set. So while connection, you want a connection string. While connecting your database with the VB.NET, you want a connection string, and that connection string that I have copied just before creating the wizard. So I just wanted to check whether it works for me or not by showing this message as connected. Let's check. Yes, this gives us connected message. That means the connection has been done successfully. Now, after the connection, I want to populate that grid view with the data. For that, I have to fire a query with data adapter. DA is equal to new SQL data adapter, and here query select star from teacher. Just pass a connection object that we have created in earlier step, and with the help of that data adapter, fill the data set that you have declared here. So I have filled that data set, and to show and to show that data into the data grid view 1, use the property data source and set that ds.tables of 0. Now check whether it shows us data. Yes, this is a coding way to connect our database with the VB.NET. Now what if I wanted to insert or update or delete some data into the database or from the database? In that case, you have to fire some additional queries onto the table teacher. For that, I want some tools. I'll get it from the toolbox. Just drag and drop text box 1. I'm just making the copies of text box 1 and text box 3. This one. Our teacher ID is primary key, if I am not wrong. Let's see. Just go to table, right click on it and open table definition. No, our teacher TID table is not having any primary key. I'm going to set primary key to TID. So just save that. Yes. And just open the teacher table in DataWave. Okay. Just I want to add two buttons, one for the add new and another for save. Drag and drop those buttons. Drag and drop those buttons. If you want to add labels here, teacher ID, teacher name and subject and all, you can do that. I'm going to skip those part right now. This is for add new. This is button 1 and this is for save button 2. Now our designing part is ready. Now just fire some queries. Click on add new. So for add new, I wanted to fire a scalar query that gives us a maximum teacher ID plus 1 record from the database. That means we have a teacher of ID with ID 1 and want ID 2. So in that case, I have to fire command is equal to new SQL client dot, there is no need to mention SQL client because I have imported that SQL client. SQL command select max of TID plus 1 from teacher table. That's it. This is a scalar query. A scalar query is one that returns a single value. This gives us a single value, that is in this case we'll get value 2, and I want to set that 2 value to the text box 1. So text box 1 dot text is equal to command dot execute scalar. We have 4 methods listed here, but I want to fire a scalar query. In that case I will execute scalar method of command object. This gives us a single value, and I want to make that button 2, which is our save button, as enable equal to true. In that case you can click on that command button 2. So now I want to insert that record. So but I don't want to insert an empty record, that is why I'm checking here if textbox 1 dot text is not equal to empty and textbox 2 dot text is not equal to empty and also textbox 3 dot text is not equal to empty. If these all text boxes are not empty, then I want to insert these values into the teacher table. So cmd equal to new SQL command insert into teacher values. Our TID is an integer value, that is number value, numeric field. That is why I'm not going to add a single code here. So just in case of a text value or varchar value or ncar value, you have to add single code here. But this field, TID field, is a numeric field. This is why I'm adding double quotes only. And cint textbox1 dot text. Say and convert that text value into the integer field. Double quotes complete, comma, single quote, double quote, space, and text box 2 dot text. And just for the concatenation, double quote, single quote, double quote, you have to add single quote, double quote, and in case that field is a text field or varchar field or anchor field, single quote, double quote, space, and text box 3 dot text. Values, brackets completed, insert double quotes completed, comma, a live connection that we have created on the form load. This query is executable non-query. So in case you want to fire insert, update, or delete queries, you have to call execute non-query function of command object. It will fire your query with insert, update, or delete operation. So in this case, I just wanted to show data inserted. If this query successfully has been successfully fired, and I want to show that data again, inserted data again into the data grid view. That is why I'm copying this data set and data adapter and all here, and I want to clear the previous records from the data set. That is why I'm adding clear method of data set here. Now let's check whether we are able to insert into the database or not. Just click on play. Okay, click on add new. We are getting 2 here, means our max plus 1 query has been fired. Now I want to add and db.net. Just data inserted, and here we get our inserted data. So this is for insert button.